Good day. This is Rob Jolliffe from Sabre Limited, and today I'd like to do a quick demo overview of manufacturing in Dynamics 365 Business Central. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go through some of the main features of Dynamics 365 Business Central as they relate specifically to manufacturing. So let's get started right away. There's a number of features that I want to demonstrate, and we'll start with the first one. So make to order. Let's take a look at make to order in Dynamics 365. Here I am in Dynamics 365 Business Central. I'm in Kronos, Canada, and I'm going to start a new sales order. So in the sales order, I'm going to choose a customer, and I'll put in a requested delivery date. So now what I want to do is I want to put in an item, and I'm going to choose my bicycle, which should be item 1000. And a bicycle has a bill of material. And so therefore what I'm going to be able to do is I'm going to be able to plan this bill of material. And as you can see, I already have a warning that I have not got enough inventory in the location I'm in. So I'm going to go in and place an order for that. So I'm going to go into planning, and here I have my bicycle. It's telling me that I don't have enough, so I can now process that plan, and I can create a production order. It's going to prompt me for what type of production order I'm going to create, and I also have the ability to either create the order as a simple order, which I'm then going to use normal planning to make any subcomponents, or as a project order where it's going to basically make the order for the bicycle and for all of the subcomponents at the same time. I'm going to do this one. Okay, so the next thing we want to try is replenishment. Talk about replenishment, talk about how the system works from a replenishment point of view. All right, here we are in Business Central. We're in Kronos, Canada, and I have the list of items that go into a bicycle. So let's take a quick look at a rim. So here's a good example of something that you might want to see or that you might see. It's got an image of the rim that you would be buying. And what we can do is we could scroll down through the different areas of data, and we'll see that there's a replenishment section. So let's take a look at that. And we have a lot of different choices to configure for this item from the point of view of replenishment. So particularly we can define whether it's purchased, produced through a production order, or assembled through an assembly. If it is produced or assembled, we can define whether it's make to stock or make to order. We can put in a lead time calculation. So let's say this rim takes about 7 days to get from our vendor. We can identify what the primary vendor and their vendor number is for this and what its units of measure are. We can also block it from being able to be purchased if we want to. So we can control the replenishment in that way. Okay, now let's look at item planning factors. So we've determined that we can replenish items in different ways. Now what we want to do is look at when we're doing replenishment, when we're having the system auto recommend replenishment, how can it do that? What are the different choices we have? So let's look at our rim again. And let's go down and scroll past replenishment. We'll collapse that. And we'll look at planning. Planning factors are part of the MRP system, and they're very very standard for ERPs. The Dynamics Business Central product has a very robust planning MRP functionality. We have a number of different types of planning we can choose from blank, which means that we're going to manually plan this, a fixed reorder quantity, a maximum quantity, an order, which means that for each order where we need this product, there will be an order placed, and lot for lot. Let's take a look at lot for lot quickly. We have the ability to identify a safety lead time, which means the system will recommend that we place the order early to arrive early, and that will be added to the lead time from the supplier. A safety stock, quantity that we should keep in stock at all times. A lot accumulation period, which is a very powerful tool. It allows us to say, for instance, that we want to accumulate 4 weeks worth of orders together. We want to look out at our bicycle requirements over 4 weeks, pull that together and place an order. We can have a rescheduling period. Let's say every 2 weeks we want it to reschedule. And we can have minimum order quantities, maximum order quantities, and order multiples. We only want to order multiples of two. Maybe this is sold in packs of two, or they're bound to each other when they're bought. A minimum order quantity, you'll notice, is five, which is not a multiple of two. It'd probably be a little bit better if I made that six. So now we'll look at bills of material and routings. So here we have our bill of material list. And let's take a look at the chain assembly. So chain assembly is pretty straightforward. Basically, what this bill of material is telling us is that we need three different components to make a chain assembly. We need a chain, one piece of chain, a chain wheel front, one chain wheel front, also a piece, and a chain wheel back. Let's look at the bicycle itself. It's a bit bigger of an assembly, larger BOM. So as you can see, a bike needs a front wheel, a back wheel, the chain assembly, which is itself got a bill of material, obviously, the mud guard, the lamp, the bell, the brake, the handlebars, the saddle, etc. Let's look at a routing. So here are the routings. There aren't as many routings as there are bills of material. So we can define routings or not depending on what we need, but let's look at the routing for the bicycle. So the bicycle goes through four steps in its manufacturing process. The wheel assembly, the chain assembly, a final assembly, and a control, which is usually a quality check. For each of these, there's a setup time and a runtime, which is shown in minutes. Generally, in the Dynamics Business Central, the standard is to use minutes. However, it also supports any other type of time that you'd like, so you can do things in seconds or hours, depending on what makes the most sense for you. Item cost shares. Now that we've looked at the bill of material and routing for the bicycle, let's take a look at the item cost shares for the bicycle. So this is going to define how much it costs to make a bike based on exploding out the materials and labor required to put it together. So if we go to navigate, under bill of materials, we have this choice called a cost share. And this report gives us a breakdown of everything that goes into making a bike. So we're going to have at the top level of this, as you can see, it's indented. We're going to have the bicycle itself. And then we're going to have the quantity that we require for the parent. So you may notice sometimes that these two numbers don't match, and that would be a case where in our parent, we need a quantity of one of something, but in our component, we may need two, and there's two components, just as an example. So if we scroll across, I'm going to see a rolled up cost and a total cost. And it breaks out by material, capacity cost, which is labor, subcontractor cost, overheads, capacity overhead, manufacturing overhead and capacity overhead, and scrap cost, to give me a total, $350 per bicycle. Now, let's say we increase our standard lot size of bicycle. So we'll go down and take a look at replenishment. And there's a lot size of 10. So $350 is to make 10 bicycles. But let's triple that and say we'll be making bicycles in lots of 30 now. We could make 10 if we want, but we prefer to make 30. Let's look at our cost shares now. The system is going to recalculate, and we now have reduced the cost of making a bicycle to $341 because with a quantity of 30, we're able to amortize our setup time and possibly some of our scrap, depending on how the scrap is defined, across more bikes. Therefore, we have a lower setup cost, possibly lower scrap cost, and are able to produce the bikes more efficiently. Now, let's look quickly at production orders. So here's a firm plan production order for a bicycle. There are three statuses of production orders that are used: planned, firm planned, and released. Planned is used more as a placeholder for purposes of calculating the amount of material you might need to buy on purchase orders. Firm planned is used to be a scheduled but not yet released production order. And released production orders are typically paperwork printed and on the floor. So if we take a look at this order, we can see that it's already been scheduled to start on the 27th of January and finish on the 30th of January. And if we look at the line, we can take a look at the components that make up this production order. So you can see that we have a quantity of one per, but because we're making 16 bicycles, we have an expected quantity of 16 and a remaining quantity of 16. As these materials are committed to this job, the expected quantity will stay the same, but the remaining quantity will drop. We can backflush the quantity so that we don't have to report it every time as well. If we look at the routing, we can see that it's intended to go through these different work centers, that the setup time here is showing the amount of time it would take to set up the machine, and then the runtime is showing the time, the runtime per piece. The starting time and ending time production is based exactly on the routing multiplied by the 16 bicycles. We can change the status of the order to a released production order, which is usually done when we're sending the work to the floor to be worked on. We can print a job card or a material requisition report, basically a pick list. We can refresh the production order, which basically will regenerate it if the bill of material were to change or the routing change. We can replan it. And we can also update the unit costs, so we can pull down up-to-date unit costs into this production order. It's quite a robust system and is used very extensively in many different forms of manufacturing. Finally, we have capacity planning in Dynamics 365 Business Central. So Dynamics 365 Business Central supports planning at various levels. We're going to look at work centers right now. Work centers are the highest level of capacity planning in the system. Let's look at an assembly department. So our assembly department has a capacity of, in the scheduling, of three, meaning that there are three simultaneous assemblies that can occur at the same time. It has a unit measure code of minutes. So once again, we can change that if we want to days, hours, minutes, seconds, whatever we really want to. In this case, we'll leave it as minutes. It uses shop calendar 1. If we look at the calendar, we can see that there are 1,440 minutes per day that are allocated or available for this machine center or work center. We can also take a look at the work center load, and we can see on a day-by-day basis how much allocated quantity there's been on that work center. As you can see here, around the time when we were looking at that production order that we'd scheduled for the bicycle, we have an allocated quantity on our capacity ledger, and you can see that we're over capacity on Thursday, meaning that we should add some overtime or perhaps reschedule some of that work to Friday. We can look at work center statistics and see what our total capacity for January is, what our effective capacity is, how much we need out of our total capacity for the entire year. I hope this demonstration has shown that Dynamics 365 Business Central has extensive capabilities in manufacturing, especially for the small-medium enterprise. We haven't talked about many of the features that are available, nor have I talked about any of the add-on modules. Check out our website or YouTube channel for more examples of features and capabilities. Thanks very much.